Philippine monetary authorities moved to address a ghost employee scandal hounding the central bank. A Banco Central statement on Tuesday said four personnel and a direct supervisor had quit. Now, amid the reports that they received hefty salaries and benefits without reporting for work. Now, the central bank says disciplinary cases were filed against them before they left the BSP. Turns out the irregularity had been the subject of a probe by an in-house counsel as early as October last year. The BSP calling the incident unprecedented. It adds it was committed to upholding the integrity and professionalism of the institution. It also addressed speculations of a shakeup in the monetary board in the wake of the scandal. The BSP says it would continue to function as normal despite vacancies in its seven-member policy-making body. San Miguel Corporation says it could still build the Pasig River Expressway after its big boss had said in March that the project was shelved. Now, San Miguel indicated this in a disclosure to the Philippine Stock Exchange. It says its affiliate, Parex Corporation, is conducting a thorough study of factors that could affect the proposed expressway. The study will be submitted and discussed with the Toll Regulatory Board. San Miguel President and CEO Ramon Ang previously said a Parex project would not push through amid opposition from environmentalists and heritage advocates. Now, transport advocates earlier expressed doubt whether the Pasig River Expressway could decongest Metro Manila's major roads. A local digital bank calls for a review of the bank secrecy law to combat the rise of so-called money mule scams in the digital economy. Money mules involve depositors who illegally transfer funds on behalf of another person. GoTime says it wants a review of the law as it prevents banks from sharing vital data needed to combat the scam.
A lot of collaboration, a lot of understanding the whole context, the whole landscape that we are in. But at the same time, one of the key things that we see is that this includes a lot of sharing of information, which at present, unfortunately, we don't have. So we have started in that build of information, in that build of database. But of course, as banks, we are bounded by regulations, mm-hmm. and one of those is the bank secrecy law. It's something that we are looking into, mm-hmm. and how can we be able to leverage on regulations, but at the same time, push forward with a solution. What we're looking also is the potential review of the bank secrecy law. Uh-huh. Hopefully, it would come soon or sooner. And in addition with that, as we review the bank secrecy law, having another set of law on anti-financial scams, which would give our current cybersecurity law more teeth.
Power distributor Meralco nears completion of a feasibility study on setting up a small nuclear power plant in the Philippines. Its COO told the company's shareholders in their annual meeting the study is being conducted with an American nuclear firm. Meralco is eyeing to develop a micro-modular reactor with a capacity of up to 15 megawatts. Meralco's EVP Ronnie Aperocho says their foray into the nuclear space is also to help the government diversify the country's energy mix by 2030.
As we deep dive into the safety, financial, and site selection parameters, our goal is to build a micro-modular reactor and have some sort of a proof of concept that will help us convince Filipino people that nuclear energy is safe, reliable, cheap, and clean source of baseload power which our country badly needs.
Another power interruption hits the Ninoy Aquino International Airport on Tuesday, with airport authorities warning this may not be the last for this year. The details from Andrea Taguines.
For the first time in 5 years, Edlyn Nardo was finally able to come home to the Philippines on Tuesday after her stint as an overseas Filipino worker in Bahrain. But her reunion with her family was further delayed since her arrival coincided with the preventive power maintenance activity at Terminal 3 of the Ninoy Aquino International Airport from 12 a.m. to 3 a.m. This caused a temporary power outage at several arrival areas, at the immigration counters and other establishments.
Mainit, sobrang walang kuryente, tapos ang haba ng pila. Tapos wala pang cart sa loob, naubusan.
This also came as a shock to the Tolentino family, who had just returned from a vacation in Japan.
Sobrang, yun nga, sabi niya, bakit ganun, brownout ba or what? Tapos ang haba ng pila, tapos yung mga, like yung mga nasa likod namin, mga galit na kasi tatawagin, tapos ipapabalik nila.
The Manila International Airport Authority apologized for the inconvenience experienced by some passengers. Because even though it had generator sets on standby, its priority was to keep essential equipment and facilities running, and less so the lights and air conditioning.
For example, yung check-in tuloy-tuloy, yung immigration tuloy-tuloy, security tuloy-tuloy, at saka yung boarding tuloy-tuloy. Tapos yung aircon medyo tamang-taman.
MIA assured the public no flights were affected by the power interruption. It also vowed to issue more advisories about such activities in the future so as not to alarm passengers.
Siguro mali din namin, hindi namin di-remind na re-remind. Hindi naman po pwedeng araw-araw re-remind mo. No? Kasi iba-ibang grupo yan eh. Maybe some na hindi nakabasa o hindi narinig yung announcement natin. So nagugulat.
The airport management had announced beforehand that there would again be a series of maintenance activities at Terminal 3 from April 2 to May 28, so it can complete the upgrading of deteriorating electrical systems there. This is to avoid a repeat of the total power outage that occurred in May and June of 2023, which resulted in many flight cancellations and had left thousands of passengers stranded. MIA is hopeful that this would be the last power interruption at the Philippines' main gateway. But it admits, conducting maintenance works isn't exactly the most sustainable solution.
Kailangan namin na baguhin lahat yung source ng power. In fact, ang ultimate solution dyan is to have our own power plant. Talagang power plant na hindi namin kaya at this point because it's too expensive. And besides, I hope that with the privatization, napapasok yung consortium, eh sila nang gagawa nun.
Meanwhile, the issue with the baggage handling system over at NAIA Terminal 1 has also been resolved. A few days ago, some X-ray machines and conveyor belts at the departure area were damaged, leading to the piling up of baggages. According to MIA, no flights were affected by the incident since it promptly deployed more personnel and canine bomb sniffers to conduct manual security checks. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. vows several improvements in Manila's main gateway will be felt starting next year. Speaking to the Filipino community in Brunei, he said billions of pesos will be spent to upgrade the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. Mr. Marcos says while the full rehabilitation of NAIA will take years, upgrades will be evident by 2025.
Pagbalik po ninyo sa Pilipinas, we hope to also welcome you to a new and upgraded Manila International Airport. Dahil sinimulan na po natin, dahil nakakahiya naman po, eh, yung airport natin, napabayaan na ng husto. At pagka yung mga pinag-aaral tungkol sa mga airport, hindi maganda po ang report sa airport natin sa Maynila. Kaya tayo ay kakalagda rin po natin. Meron tayo po 170.6 billion pesos na idadalhin para pagandahin ang ating mga passenger terminal, ang ating mga airside facilities, at saka mas madali ang paglipat mula sa isang terminal hanggang sa kabilang terminal, mula sa airport hanggang sa terminal ng bus para makauwi sa probinsya.
Back in February, a consortium led by the San Miguel Group won the bidding for NAIA's rehabilitation with a price tag of 170 billion pesos.